rising high above mediocrity, overcoming the structured middle-class lifestyle of white suburbia. Ladies and gentlemen, I present to you Tater at 60. Skywatch Studios. Here's Tater.
Hey, thank you. Hey, thank you very much. Hey, welcome to Tater's birthday bash. Hey, that's right. Hey, I'm 60 years old. Can you believe it? Hey, you know who else is 60 years old this year? Captain Crunch. Hey, there's some other notable celebrities turning 60 this year also. There's Michael Jordan and Charles Barkley. John Stamos, Uncle Jesse from Full House. Larry the Cable Guy, Michael Myers. And then there's two Phoebes. That's right, Phoebe Cates from Fast Times at Ridgemont High. And then there's Lisa Kudrow, who played Phoebe Boucher on the hit TV series Friends. And then there's Deuce Bigelow himself, Rob Schneider. Hey, don't forget about Johnny Depp. And of course, Brad Pitt. Hey, and there's a couple celebrities who didn't quite make it to 60. They should have, but they didn't. And that's Whitney Houston and George Michael. Hey, that's right, 1963, baby. 1963, hey. I got a big adventure lined up for you, so let's get things started. Away we go. All right, folks, let's get things started. A few months back, I started contemplating my birthday adventure. Seeing that I was turning 60, I wanted to do something extra special. So I took a few days and thought about it long and hard, and I came up with something that I've always wanted to do. Hey, have a look.
Silver rains for gold and leave them.
Wow. Hey, that was a blast. I went on two different airboat rides through the Florida Everglades. That's right. Hey, I left Louisville, Kentucky on Tuesday, May 23rd, flew to Tampa, Florida, picked up a rental car, and drove 3 hours south to a little village called Everglade City. Hey, it's basically an island in the middle of the Everglades. 400 residents live there, and it's known for its airboat rides and its fishing guides. On the morning of May 24th, my 60th birthday, I got up, I ate breakfast at the island house, and then I drove to Captain Jack's airboat rides and proceeded to have the time of my life. Hey, we have a video chat from Herbie.
Hey, Tater, happy birthday from the Shire. Yorkshire, that is. Hey, Tater, while you were in the Florida Everglades, did you encounter any alligators? Toodaloo!
Hey, that's a good question there, Herbie. Hey, and it's always good to hear from you. Hey, as a matter of fact, I did have an encounter with an alligator. Hey, have a look. May through October is considered the off season in Southwest Florida. Not many tourists were around, and that's the way I like it. But April, May, and June, well, that's mating season for the gators. The males become very territorial and don't want other males in their area. And the females, well, they get very aggressive in other ways. I rolled into town about 5 p.m. I stayed at a hotel called the Captain's Table Resort. It had what I call an old Florida-style feel to it. Yeah, it was a bit tacky, but I really liked that place. It had a big, warm outdoor pool that I had all to myself. And it overlooked beautiful Lake Placid. It was within walking distance of the island house where I had breakfast each morning. After the swim, I dressed and drove down the road to the Diving Pelican restaurant and bar. That's a good way to meet some local folks. Then I went to the Camellia Street Grill for dinner. This was a really cool looking place. The view out back was amazing,
I had the blackened scallops. The next morning, while waiting on airboat rides to open, I drove around town. It didn't take long, as it's a small town. As you can see, this is a fishing village. Stone crabs are the main harvest around these parts, but they currently are out of season. You can see all the crab cages stacked up and waiting for the next season to arrive. After my airboat adventures, I was hungry, so I stopped by the City Seafood Restaurant, another cool place. I had the grilled grouper sandwich. Hey, look, the nation's smallest post office. After that, I drove south to Chokoloski Island. There I found Smallwood's Trading Post, built in 1917. The locals and the Seminole Indians would come here to trade goods. It's a museum and gift shop nowadays, and it's known to be haunted. On the other side of those mangrove trees is the Gulf of Mexico. I was ready for a swim, but a storm was blowing in, so I decided to go eat. I headed back to Camellia Street Grill. I had the blackened Maui. Man, it don't get no better than this. Folks, that was just a short adventure in the Florida Everglades, and I hope to go back. Man, what a cool place. Very laid back. I could get used to a lifestyle like that. Hey, it's getting time to wrap up this episode, but I would like to say a few things first. A couple of my viewers are going through some tough times. And hey, you know who you are. Hey, here at Tater's Outdoor Adventures, we are keeping you in our thoughts and in our prayers. And I have one more thing to say. Hey, old Tater has friends and old Tater has family, but Tater's best friends is his family. Hey man, I love every one of you. And hey, you know how I roll. If I can do it, you can do it too. Hey. See you on down the road.
No cross too bad.